In our last video, we showed how to create a console application that could configure and read messages from the CAN bus using API calls available in our CANlib SDK. In this video, we will focus on how to make your read loop event-driven to be more efficient. In the previous examples, we used a C# console application. Since we want to show the event-driven loop in a multiple thread application, this example will use a Windows Presentation Foundation program where the main thread handles the graphic user interface and a background thread reads the data from the CAN bus. We have a simple graphic user interface with one button to start the background thread and one button to stop the background thread. We've also added a text box to display the received messages. We've designed this GUI using XAML. We'll use a .NET background worker thread to perform all the CAN bus manipulation. This means that we must include the system component model namespace and create the background worker when the main window is created. All that's left for the GUI to do is to start the background worker when the bus on button is pressed, stop the background worker when the bus off button is pressed, and display the string reported from the background thread. Background worker will execute the receive message loop function to retrieve data from the CAN bus. Like in our previous examples, we need to include CANlib CLSNet namespace and set up a handle to the Kvaser device. We've placed the handle setup calls in the initialize channel function. We initialize the library, get a handle, set the bit rate, and make the channel active on the bus. We have also added a call to CAN.io control to get a Windows event handle that will trigger when something happens in the driver. That something could be a message received, message transmitted, or a change in the CAN controller state. Regardless of why the event triggered, you must empty the receive buffer or you will not get another event trigger. You'll notice that the pointer returned by CAN.io control must be placed inside a class derived from the wait handle class. To use the wait handle class, we must include the system threading namespace. We now have a properly initialized channel handle and an event handle. So back in the receive message loop, we loop until the GUI requests the background worker to stop. Inside the loop, we wait up to 1 second for an event to occur using the waitAny method. If the CAN event does trigger, we loop reading messages with the CANRead call until the function indicates the receive buffer is empty with a CANError no message status. For each message processed, we pass the message information back to the GUI with the report progress method built into the background worker class. If the GUI requests the background worker to stop, we fall out of the while loop to the release channel function, which handles our standard cleanup by making the channel inactive and closing the handle. Now the application is still responsive while using less CPU resources since we're only checking for messages and updating the display when a CAN event or user event occurs. Keep in mind when using multiple threads that the handle returned by the CAN open channel call is not thread safe. So each thread must claim their own handle to the physical channel with the CAN open channel function.